now I'd like to ask Rabbi Kass to come up, but I can't do that without say a few words about a person that doesn't need an introduction, but does. As I understand, a former rabbi of East Midwood, chaplain of the police, right? Been involved in everything I've ever been involved in, practically. He's been there, and he's been a centerpiece. And the one thing you know, when he walks into a room, there's a certain dignity that he brings to it. And everybody recognizes it. Everybody comes up to him, looking up to him. And so we couldn't be more pleased and proud that you have taken the time to come here to give us a small Dvar Torah to begin with. And the most important thing, he's a member of our Brooklyn Jewish, BJHI Brooklyn Jewish Hall of Fame, class of?
I don't remember the year.
Good evening. It's a great pleasure to be here. This is a night about history. I have to tell you something that is an important historical footnote. This synagogue, the East Midwood Jewish Center, is the only synagogue in the world that has a cop who became a rabbi here and another cop who became the president of the synagogue, and that's Steve Litwin. A lot of cops have traversed these premises over the years. But this has been a synagogue which really is so much a part of New York City's history. I remember going to the Museum of the City of New York. They had an exhibit on the Lindsay years. The Lindsay years were very important to me because it was John Lindsay, Mayor John Lindsay, who appointed me to be the Jewish chaplain of the police department. I had never known him before, but we got to be good friends after he became mayor and after I became a chaplain. And I saw this exhibit of the Lindsay years, and I was walking around the premises, and I see something on the wall that looks very familiar. And I went over and I see it's the front page of the Daily News, and there's a picture of the East Midwood Jewish Center. This picture dates from the Lindsay years because there was a tremendous crowd gathered around his limousine trying to turn it over. It consisted of Jewish teachers. John Lindsay, if you ever knew him, had a marvelous gift. He could go into hostile audiences and win them over in a few words. But he did not win over an audience here at the East Midwood Jewish Center. He had enacted certain bits of legislation which many Jewish teachers felt threatened their position in the city. And as a result of that, they had to take him out the back door of the synagogue. Some years later, he came to East Midwood at my son's bar mitzvah, and he wrote a note to me afterwards saying, "It was such a pleasure to come back to East Midwood in a much friendlier environment." So his involvement and participation in this synagogue had many ramifications. I've always felt awed by being able to be part of this synagogue. For so many years, almost a half century, the rabbi here was Harry Halpern. Harry Halpern was a legend in the American rabbinate. I recall when I came out of the Air Force and the United Synagogue of America asked me if I would edit their quarterly publication, the United Synagogue Review, I would invite Harry Halpern to write articles for the magazine. And they were always very, very well received. He was someone who was known from one end of this country to the other. And little did I know that one day I would stand at the pulpit here. And I have to tell you that to this day, I am 88 years old. I am the rabbi. I've been emeritus here since 2014, but every time I have ever stood at that pulpit, no matter how old I am, I feel like I'm a little boy, and I feel awed by the fact that I can't help but think that Harry Halpern spoke from this pulpit. So I had someone who preceded me who was probably the most famous rabbi in America. And I had a rabbi who succeeded me, who sings so beautifully and speaks so eloquently. So I feel sandwiched in by superlatives on both sides. And I feel honored to be in such distinguished company. Harry Halpern became a good friend of mine, and Sam Levine is a very dear friend of mine. And this is a place where you make friends and you do things that are important. I remember over the years when we were trying to get the Jews out of the Soviet Union and out of Syria, and that organization is being honored here tonight, we would have Simcha Torah services out in the street. Those services were known all over, and their pictures were all over the world. And we stimulated so much sentiment, which led to the exodus of Soviet Jewry. We're very, very proud of that chapter. And I'll tell you something else. After the Jews came out of the Soviet Union, we are proud to have had here the most outstanding program anywhere, which helped to Americanize the Soviet immigrants who came to this country. The people who graduated from that program went on to great things, including one gentleman who became the chief of staff of the New York City Police Department. We're celebrating the Bridge, Multicultural Bridge Organization. I recall being with my children, walking across the span of the Brooklyn Bridge on the occasion of the 100th birthday of that great monumental symbol of what New York City and Brooklyn are all about. As far as Hadassah is concerned, anyone who's been a member of Brooklyn Hadassah knows that at my house on 1188 East 21st Street, for many years, the big annual fundraiser was a concert at which my wife was one of the principal participants. Hadassah and my life and this synagogue and its role in New York, they're all intertwined. This has been the center of Jewish life for so many, many years. It's been a center of communal life. And I, for one, am delighted to be able to come down here tonight to be able to celebrate with you so many important institutions that have played a pivotal role here in New York City and indeed in the country. History doesn't get the due that it's entitled to. The truth of the matter is that the word history comes from the word story, the story of life is history. And we know, as we learn about the past, that whatever we do is rooted in what came before us. Whatever East Midwood, Hadassah, the fighters for the Multi-Bridge Alliance, and those who have battled in behalf of any great cause, knows that we are standing on the shoulders of giants. So God bless those who have created the history of the past, even as I know all of you will be creating the history of the future. God bless you all, and may it be a very successful evening.